I was Googling kidney stones the other day and the treatment for it. The main treatment is ultrasonic shockwave treatment. They send a blast of ultrasound through your kidney. What they're doing is they're sending a punch through your kidney. Side effects include bleeding and internal damage. You can even lose the function of the kidney because they're punching you in the kidney with a shockwave of ultrasound. Now, I saw nowhere the resonant frequency of kidney stones. What about the principles of harmonic resonance? They have it in demonstrations in classrooms all the time. A frequency generator generating ordinary sound and shattering a wine glass. Everything has its own resonant frequency. Kidney stones are crystals. They're made primarily, most of them, 75% of them, are made from calcium oxalate. Now, all you have to do is find the average resonant frequency of calcium oxalate, get an ultrasound monitor, put an oscilloscope on it, and then when you reach the right frequency and it starts resonating, you can see the sine wave, you can see it. And then you just turn up the power, pump up the volume. And then the crystal, this kidney stone, will break. Even large ones. Oh, by the way, this ultrasound shockwave system does not work. It's not used on the larger crystals, on the larger kidney stones. It's primitive and it's outdated. But, on the other hand, they do that for a reason. If they use harmonic resonance to find the resonant frequency of the kidney stone and shatter it gently that way, without harming any body tissue, without punching a shockwave through your kidney, they might start thinking, gee, what is the resonant frequency, whether it be sound or electromagnetic or electrical, of cancer cells? The cancer treatment industry, by the way, is a multi-billion dollar a year industry. If you were to take away all of their drugs and their radiation and replace it with simple frequency generators to resonate the cancer cells at their resonant frequency and pop their membrane, the drug companies would lose their shirts. So millions of people die needlessly from cancer, a disease that can be cured. In fact, a man named Royal Wright in the 1930s discovered the cure for cancer and all other diseases caused by pathogens. You just find the resonant frequency of the organism or the cell, and you resonate that organism or the cell at its own specific resonance, and you will destroy it. No drugs, no chemotherapy, no radiation, no barbarism. Just a quick, simple, cheap, inexpensive cure. The drug companies don't want that. So if you get cancer, you're probably going to die because they're greedy.